In this Canva tutorial, you're gonna learn how to make this kind of beautiful overlappy video effect thing for your social media posts, your ads, your website, your newsletter, and wherever else you wanna use it. It is an effect that I have been using for my Skillshare teacher profile to really engage with my students, and it's really helped me stand out from the competition on the platform. So I hope it can do the same for you no matter where you end up using your creations. The first time I came across this was with breakoutclips.com. So these guys do specialize in this particular effect, but they do have a paid tool. So I wanted to see if there was a way we can recreate this using only free online tools. And that's exactly what we're gonna do in today's training. And all of the tools we're gonna be using throughout are all linked for you in the description below. So make sure to check them out there and let's get creating. When making this kind of effect, you either wanna start with a video that already has a green screen background like these ones over here, or you can kind of cheat the system a little bit by just finding a video that has a constant color in the background. So whether that's black or white, it doesn't matter what the color is, as long as there's enough contrast between the foreground and the background that you're trying to remove, it should work, but it might be a little bit glitchy. So try and find as much of a contrasted video as possible. So for the example, this one's not a great example of that because the colors are quite light. But then I know this one here is quite dark, so it makes it really easy for the video tool we're gonna be using to actually crop this out and only use that element and remove the background for us. So I'm gonna go ahead and download that. This is from pexels.com, so they've got all completely free to use videos, but you can use whatever tool you're using to get your videos from as long as they're free for you to use. And then I would just open this up in QuickTime Player on my computer and go to edit and trim just to get only a couple of seconds of what I want here, because I don't really need these bits over here. I just need it to be up to the point where the smoke is kind of coming down but not overlapping with the frame yet. So that's where I kind of want to stop with this, and I only really want to grab a couple of seconds. So it doesn't have to be, you know, super lengthy, the trimmed clip. I just want maybe 3 to 5 seconds so that it can loop really nicely and just capture enough of my audience's attention there. I'm gonna save the trimmed version, and then we're gonna jump on over to a tool called unscreen.com. So this is a really handy tool for all your GIF creation needs, and especially for using this kind of overlapping video effect. It can be really, really powerful, but keep in mind, it is a free tool. It does glitch sometimes, so it might take you a few tries to find the right kind of video where the color in the background of it is constant enough that it can really easily remove it for you. It's done a pretty good job with it, but you can see there's a tiny glitch at the end there. So we're just gonna remove that in the next tool we're gonna be using. It's no trouble at all. Okay, now I'm gonna jump on over to Easy GIF, and I'm just in the cut section here. So it's got a lot of different categories, but the first thing I'm gonna do is remove that little bit of a glitch that's at the beginning of my GIF, I think. It might be at the end. We're gonna test a few things out. But I want to remove that first and foremost because it is quite a glitchy, distracting little thing here. So I just would probably go by seconds instead of frame numbers. So you can see that the duration is 4.26 seconds. So I might put in 4.25 just to be safe. And let's see if we can cut out this glitch by just removing a couple of frames in the beginning there. Okay, that seems to have gotten rid of it, so that's excellent. And the benefit of using Easy GIF is that you don't have to download it and upload it every single time. You can kind of keep working on the version of the GIF that you've already got. So I can take this GIF and go, all right, let's increase the speed so it's nice and speedy for my audience on social media. I would either probably go double speed or at least, you know, slightly more than 1.5 times there. That's pretty good without being sort of distorted. That's important. And then we want it to come back up. So I'm gonna hit reverse, and we're just gonna say run to the end and reverse back to the start and see if that works for us. Yep, so that loops back and forth really nicely for us. So that's pretty much what we want. And now we can jump on over to Canva and include that in our design. All right, now jumping on over to Canva, I'm just going to create a LinkedIn post because that's gonna be my reference image. But if you want to create an Instagram post or something for your website or your profile, you can absolutely do that as well. This is just so it makes it really easy for me to look at what I'm doing, because I'm going to be using my own LinkedIn graphic here that I've already created. So I would just take a screenshot of this so I can have a look at what it is that I'm creating, except for obviously the reactions below, because those are on the live post. And then I can bring that into my Canva design just for inspiration. So I have something to look at as I'm designing, and I can take a look at what it is that I'm hoping to create. So I'm gonna go ahead and just bring in my looping GIF here. And then I'm gonna jump on over to LinkedIn and just bring in some of these elements that are specific to the platform to create this kind of GIF. So let's take a look at where I can grab some reactions that I've had on a recent post. I also just need to grab this bit here. I don't necessarily need to grab the text, but it's just for a little bit of reference for myself, so I know what this is supposed to look like. And obviously this is going to be a part of the graphic as well. So I'm going to go ahead and bring that in here. Now I'm going to hold down option and drag so that I can copy this across, because I actually want two versions of these elements so that I can kind of cut out the bits that have the analytics in there, because obviously that looks like it's my back-end stats and not an organic post coming across somebody's feed. And I would also probably stretch these out past the point where you can see the rounded corners, just to make it a little bit nice and clean. And I might bring that up a tiny bit to give this text here a little bit extra room here. And now it's time to create the actual graphic itself. So I would just head on over to Elements and bring in a bit of a background here so that I can give myself something to work with. And again, I'll hold down option or just copy and paste so that I can remove the date stamp just over here, so that I can keep things nice and clean, and then just using the arrow keys to space that down, just so that when it's coming across somebody's feed, it looks like it's happening in real time. And obviously this is maybe not the color that I'm going for here. And I would also just use an image of myself to cut myself out and put myself in this kind of graphic. If you're not on Canva Pro and you don't have the background remover tool, then don't worry about this too much. There is free tools out there that can do this for you, and you can bring in the image cutout of yourself already ready for you to go within Canva. But I'm gonna go ahead and hit apply, and then I also wanna just put in a little bit of text that's going to kind of appear out of nowhere when we put in our beautiful looping GIF. So it's nice to use big bold text for this kind of graphic, and you can pick from all these different options here, but I'm just going to pick this one and say something like, make magic happen. And I would probably try and spread that out over two lines if at all possible, to just give it a little bit more extra flair. But, and then we can move that down, maybe just play around with the line spacing a little bit and try and make it as big as possible to give it that extra wow factor when your overlapping graphic comes into it. So I can position this just backwards so that even my cutout here is like slightly over this text here. And now I just need to make sure I'm bringing that into the same color as my background, and then I'll essentially put the GIF in between them. So in my uploads within the video section, I've got my looping GIF here, and I just want to make sure I'm stretching that out and also positioning that in a way that it makes it really easy to read all the text that you've got going on there, and it's overlapping on top of my entire graphic. Now, if you're going to be posting this on LinkedIn, you can change the text here. So you would just put a white text box over the text that you have there and just change the text to whatever you wanted to say. And then you would just go on over to downloading this as a GIF. I also like using a desaturated image of myself in the background there, because it makes things pop a little bit more for extra effect. But then I would just go ahead and either download that as a video and it would just kind of keep looping for you, or you can download it as a GIF, and it's as easy as that. And that's it for today's Canva training on how to create an overlapping video effect for your social media posts. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel so you never miss a future training like this one. And if you want to check out my best-selling Skillshare course all about Canva, it's in the description below for you as well. Thanks so much for being here, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.